Big wave riding is not for the faint-hearted and can even turn off the most experienced surfers. But for 54-year-old Garrett McNamara, it's a dream he refuses to give up.
We were a team and we stumbled across something super special. Nazaré.
Nazaré isn't like any other big wave spot. It's a different animal.
This is where the biggest wave in the world is.
It stands up so tall.
I found what I've been looking for so many years. I need search no more.
In 2011, the American thrill seeker carved up one of the biggest waves ever surfed. And now his documentary, 100 Foot Wave, details that journey. Garrett McNamara joins us now from Portugal. Garrett, it's a pleasure to speak to you. First off, what made you start chasing these swells? And what made you think, yeah, I can do this?
I just fell in love with big waves and it became my job. It became the way I put food on the table. It's my passion and my job. So it was amazing. That's what I got to do since I was 17 years old.
Wow.
To us, it looks absolutely terrifying, I have to say. But to you, I guess not. The coast of Nazaré forms some of the biggest waves in the world. What draws you to it? Do you have no fear?
You know, we go out there and get so many experiences and all of a sudden it becomes comfortable and you have to learn how to enjoy the underwater rides. And once you learn how to enjoy the underwater rides, everything else is fun.
Is that underwater rides as in desperately trying to get back up to the top for air?
Relaxing, totally staying calm and waiting for that final second when you get to get your lips out of the water.
That's what I imagine. Yeah, I'm so fascinated with the preparation that might go into this with big wave events. I mean, like I said before, I'm scared of things. Like, even on a roller coaster, the thought of that, even though at the end I know that I'm going to be safe. How do you prepare for these big wave events? Because I'd imagine, as big as they look, they seem even bigger when you're in them.
Yeah, I won't swim with sharks. I won't ride a horse. I'm afraid of horses. So I'm not really a thrill seeker. But what was the question? Sorry.
How was the preparation for the big waves? I mean, is your motivation, is fear of some way your motivation between these?
Fear, not the motivation, all passion.
Yep.
And the preparation is mostly in the gym or in the ocean getting pounded. And a lot of hold your breath exercises, a lot of strength training, a lot of bands. I've been working out. I wake up every morning at 5 a.m. I go to the gym and then I come home and make the plan for the day.
Wow.
You broke the record in 2011 and held the title for around 5 years. Did you know that was going to be the day?
No, I had no idea. I actually went out there to take my friends to get waves. I wasn't planning on surfing that day. So it was a very selfless approach and ended up being rewarded with a very special wave.
Wow. Yeah, you just mentioned the passion there. From the crest of the wave, I mean, you're flying down in seconds. Well, what's that feeling like?
If you've ever gone snowboarding or...
No, I fell down a few times.
Snowboarding or skiing and you're coming down moguls and they're icy moguls and then you have an avalanche chasing you, or you're driving in a car super fast on a snowy road and then there's an avalanche coming down and instead of trying to run away from it, you kind of stay right under it as close as you can and maybe get barreled and come out.
Oh, God. You mentioned in the doco that when you first started, there was no wave too big or too dangerous. Have your thoughts on risk changed at all over the years?
I'm more patient and more calculated. Like, you in Australia, you have Shipstern's Bluff, but I have no interest in going over that step. And you have hours. I have no interest in going through that. I did surf hours back in the day. I would have surfed Shipsterns back in the day, but these days I have no interest. I'm focused on perfect waves, and if they're perfect, I'll be out there if I'm feeling up to it. And if it's 100 foot, 120 foot and perfect, I'll be out there. If it's not very good conditions and all the other boys are out there going for it, I'll let them have it. And I'll either drive or have a nice watch from the cliff.
Well, you don't sound like you plan on hanging up your board anytime soon. The quest for the 100-foot wave continues.
Yeah, I'm only 54, so I got 50 more years, I guess.
There you go.
That's the best thing I've heard today. That is fantastic. Well, 100-foot wave premieres on Foxtel this Thursday at 7:30 p.m. You're an absolute legend, Garrett. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you. Love you all down in Australia. Can't wait to come visit again.